Reports coming out that Green Bay Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers secretly all this time has been unjabbed. But he told a different story in August when he was asked the question of his status. And now things are getting crazy. We're going to get into all the details and much more in just a second, guys. First, if you could, please like this video, share it, hit the bell, subscribe, and wear the glasses because I'm blind. Also, if you could, guys, consider making a generous donation here to our ministry. As we're demonetized on YouTube, they don't support us. You could help us out in a major way, though. If you enjoy the daily video content we put out talking about end time Bible prophecy headlines and our ministry here of getting people to Jesus Christ, you can help out through PayPal or Patreon, or even just $5 a month on Patreon will get you bonus content. Plus, we include the links to the YouTube videos so you get all alerts when new content arrives. You can comment censorship-free, send direct messages. It's a great way to stay up to date with all the content we put out here. Another big reminder I can't stress enough, go sub to me on Rumble. That's our backup in case we're kicked off of YouTube. We already post there, so go check it out. All those links are down below. A big thank you to everybody already contributing and for those thinking of doing so. Thank you as well. Your generosity is greatly appreciated. So what went on here with Aaron Rodgers? Well, it was revealed that he has tested positive for Rona, which actually happened just today. And now because of this, he's expected to miss, well, he will miss the November 7th game against the Kansas City Chiefs. But there could be more on the line here because, well, when the report came out, it was also said that apparently, all this time, Rodgers has not been jabbed. Now, to the normal people out there, like myself and all of you out there watching me, we're saying to ourselves, who cares? It's his personal choice. But for these other people in the NFL, oh, no. It's a big deal. Now, it was back in August that a reporter had asked Rodgers the question of whether or not he had been jabbed. His response, and now looking back on it, was kind of clever. He said, yes, I have been immunized against it. Now, he used that word immunized. He didn't say jab. He said immunized. But then he also talked about the fact that there were others on the team who were not jabbed, but that he believed that everybody had the right to make their own personal decision. So obviously, he's somebody that has respected that all this time. Now, on another note with Rodgers, you know, I can respect this guy because even recently he's been coming out, speaking out against cancel culture and speaking out against all these crazy people, you know, and defending manhood and everything. So he has my respect for that. And I know why he did what he did here. Now, you got to remember with the NFL, they have these protocols in place for people who are not jabbed. And they're required to have to wear the face diapers when they're around, you know, teammates. And if they come down with the Rona, well, then they're basically barred from all, you know, team activities for up to 10 days. And so this also now, you know, brings into question whether or not he'll be able to actually play in the November 14th game against the Seattle Seahawks. So he's facing all of this now at the same time. However, here is what also reportedly was going on all this time since the beginning of the season. Rodgers apparently went to the NFL and he asked for an exemption to the jab. They did not give it him. They did not give one to him. Not a surprise there because the NFL is a big joke. We know this. So what he had been doing instead was that he had been doing homeopathic therapy with his own personal doctor at home and in order to supposedly increase his antibodies to be able to fight off Rona if he did, you know, at some point come down with it, that he'd be able, you know, to continue testing and he wouldn't get it. So this is what he had been doing all along. And I guess he was hoping this would be an acceptable alternative to getting the jab. But the NFL said, nope, that's not going to happen. You're benched. So the therapy that he was doing here all along, maybe it was good that he did it, you know, but even, you know, nonetheless, he tested positive, whatever you want to think about the tests and how those all work. Now he's benched, and now people are coming at him. They're attacking him, calling him a liar for saying what he said in August, saying that he was immunized, obviously using that word and not using jabbed because, you know, he didn't want to actually say that word and then be held to that. He kind of danced around it, but I get why he did it because the protocol is ridiculous. I mean, the NFL, the NBA, all the sports leagues, I'm just tired of them all. They're doing everything they can to make players' lives difficult. And, you know, it might be saying, oh, why are you defending these players that make all this money? Look, I get that. But a lot of them are actually taking a stand, and many of them, especially in the NBA, you know, they've been benched. You know, they're, you know, we talk about Kyrie Irving and others that are, you know, currently not playing on home games because of their decision to not get the jab, and they're losing a lot of money because of it. And Aaron Rodgers, somebody who is speaking out here, you know, how will this affect him the rest of the season? How will it affect the team? Does he care? Is it more about himself? Now, this is somebody that is speaking out against all of these cultural issues right now. So he's yet to actually speak about this now, and the fact that people revealed that he's actually unjabbed this whole time. So we'll wait for a comment from him as far as this story coming out. It could be that already by the time you're watching this video, he might have already said something about this. But look, I could support Aaron Rodgers in this. You know, he did what he had to do. I got no respect for the NFL. Players that want to take a stand, though, I can respect that. This is all leading, though, ladies and gentlemen, to something very, very dark. Revelation chapter 13. This is where we are heading. The jab is essentially just part one of what's to come. We're getting an early preview of Bible prophecy being laid out as the Bible has spoke about in the book of Revelation. And that's why we do these videos. We talk about the prophetic news headlines going on around the world because we are in the last days and Jesus Christ is coming back soon. The question is, are you ready to meet him as your Lord and Savior? Because if not, we want to give you this opportunity right now, like we do on all of our videos, to get you to accept Jesus into your life, because that is the best decision you're ever going to make. And I'll lead you in that prayer right now. You can put it in your own words, but I'll give you the steps that you need to bring it before the Lord. Here's the first thing that you want to do, and for some it's the hardest, and that's to acknowledge that you're a sinner. It's something that we all are, but God gave his only son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for the sins of all the world. He died and rose again for you and me. He paid the cost. What you have to do, though, is repent of your sin. Now, repent means to turn from your sin, not just to say you're sorry, but to turn from lifestyles, habits, whatever it is in your life that goes against the word of God. You ask Jesus to forgive you. He'll wipe that sin away. The Bible says he won't remember it any longer. And then you invite Jesus into your life to be your Lord and Savior. When you do that, you become born again, a child of God. You will have eternal life. Trust me when I tell you, there is no greater decision you will ever make than the one you do to give your life to Christ. I pray you make that decision today. I'll have more for you guys on this down below. You can let me know your thoughts. Don't forget, the links to donate to our ministry are there as well. It is a great blessing if you could help us out. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll be back with more. You guys take care. Please be safe out there. God bless each and every single one of you, and I'll talk with you soon.